Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Goddess of Victory Nikke on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Goddess of Victory Nikke and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Goddess of Victory Nikke. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else my friends, to start we need to launch our favorite browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to that URL I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type that URL, simply because I added the link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We ended up on this page on the side of Usitility, at which we include a detailed outline on how you can download and install Goddess of Victory Nikke on laptop or computer. We search lower a little bit and mouse click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on that link, we arrive here on the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will launch to get access to that game Goddess of Victory Nikke on PC. It is now obvious that we get a great deal of advantages of preferring the emulator. So we are on the way to start downloading the Goddess of Victory Nikke by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. Next step is clicking on this button. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Voila, here is located the download. It is an executable file. What we have to do now is to run the executable file, so we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the laptop or device. We have clicked yes. I minimize the web browser to find the installation software considerably better. The installation software is really easy to follow. It contains a couple of possibilities, install, and setup path. I will explain what setup path does indeed. We basically simply click on it. And so we discover that we end up with here the path in which the emulator can be placed. If we want to modify this directory we are required to click on that browse option, and therefore we select another folder and install the emulator where we would like. I prefer to keep it where it is. I simply click back. Therefore I pick install. Fantastic. The install begins and it is going to go forward along with the download of these megabytes that are shown on our computer screen. As you download it, it is likely to be more or less megabytes. The download speed can be faster or at a lower speed, subject to your web access and depending on the performance of the emulator hosting servers. Today they're going extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator has actually been started on autopilot. As you can discover, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar which will move forward to the right then when it reaches the finish, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. The fact is that the emulator is already started, there for the very first time. Before we keep going, as can be seen, it has made a couple of app icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be the only one we're focused on. Each time we are planning to launch Goddess of Victory Nikke on our PC, we double mouse click on this particular app icon and consequently start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we make the following step, which is actually a must-have, and which is to access the Google Play Store. And we'll mouse click on Play Store. As you understand the Google Play is presented. Right here we have got to log on. Presently the moment we're on this page, we must absolutely perform the following step which is absolutely mandatory. Therefore just click on Sign In. Presently it announces Checking Info. It could occasionally get stopped at Checking Info, additionally it does not progress. In this case, you should attempt to connect to your account after a number of hours and it may probably be resolved. At this time we shall insert our email and password. The email must be a Gmail email address and its associated password. As an example you could use the very same email you're using at this time in your YouTube account. So I will provide my details and I'll return as soon as I have completed it. Voila, information typed in. Find out Google welcoming us and presenting us their terms of service. We can agree to them all by just pressing, I agree. Following that, it allows us to save to the Google Cloud. You can also keep it selected and it will produce a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you do what you want. We click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is started automatically and on autopilot. To set up the video game, we need to visit the emulator desktop by double-clicking on the app icon designated in green. At this point that we are exploring the desktop of this emulator for Android, we can see that we have now here the Install Video Game button. We click or double-click on this button. On this page we access to the game app. How about we then click right here on the Install button that I am displaying now in green color. This action will initiate the software installation. Presently it is going to download on your desktop or laptop and install the video game. It usually takes a bit of time, or perhaps it may just be very quick. This all is dependent upon on our internet connection. It has by then completed setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this particular option I'm showing in green, in order to run Goddess of Victory Nikke for the first time. You are presently on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're on the way to click this brand new Goddess of Victory Nikke icon which was provided. Your Android game is started for the very first time. Here we get it. I can press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to talk about the volume level of that emulator. This is right here. We have the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This way we don't use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of the emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the maximum, we will activate the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This one is simply the first one. We mouse click on that software icon that I'm mentioning in green color. Thus the display screen is maximized, offering one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In case that we like to have fun with the application using all the screen, we click this app icon. And we'd at present be experiencing and enjoying the gameplay in 100% screen mode. To get out of the full screen functionality, just click the F11 key. And we might now play in standard display mode. At this point, I am ready to demonstrate to you the computer keys mapping, and that is definitely very exciting. This step we will probably be in a position to make use of the video game a lot more easily. The first thing is to press this app icon. And at this time there you will have the ability to get the recommended setups. I can leave the standard configuration, though if you require to adjust that, you can also do so without any problem. Obviously, the emulator is absolutely in our own language. On occasion it occurs that your emulator is launched in the incorrect language, as an example, in Mandarin. And thus to set it up in the proper language we click here to the cogwheel. And thus right here inside of many other configuration settings, we mouse click on the language drop down. We can opt for the language we like, German, Mandarin, and so on. After the language is selected, we could save, the emulator would restart, and the game application, the next time we use it, will also be in the selected language. Presently, you will find another information that we have to take into consideration, and it's that we will receive a message from Google Mail indicating that a different electronic device has been associated with our own Google account. It should check with us if we are the ones who have connected that electronic device. Of course, we may not be troubled, since the emulator is emulating an Android smartphone or tablet. So you can identify which smartphone or tablet is currently being emulated. We visit right here, to the cogwheel, and we just click on it. Be sure you browse here to the model choice. And now we learn that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for that video user demo. I hope that you enjoyed it, especially that you found it interesting. If that's so, allow it a nice like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your comments, questions or ideas. Let them in the comment area down below. You also can comment things on my Twitch channel. I perform live streams occasionally. You get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Mouse click on any of those instructional videos that are showing up on the list of videos to watch, and see you in the future video tutorials. Bye.